वेलकम टू DSEG होम क्लासेस अ डिजिटल इनिशिएटिव बाय डायरेक्टोरेट ऑफ स्कूल एजुकेशन जम्मू। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम ज्योति दीवान। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू अ पोइम सनराइज बाय पद्मा सचदेव। द स्टोरी ऑफ दिस पोइम इज वेरी सिंपल, इंटरेस्टिंग एंड ब्यूटिफुल। थ्रू दिस सिंपल मेटाफोरिकल स्टोरी The child is made to visualize a commonplace act of nature in a fanciful, imaginative, and delightful way. There is conversion of a shy, timid, and nervous boy into a bold, assertive, and arrogant person. Now, let us know something about the poetess. Padma Sachdev is an Indian poetess and novelist. She is the first modern women poetess of Dogri language. She was born in Parbandal, Jammu in 1940 in a family of Sanskrit scholars. She is recipient of many honors including Sahitya Academy Award in 1972. Padma Sachdev is a charming, delightful and very lovable person. She wrote both in her mother tongue Dogri and national language Hindi. The poem Sunrise has been written in Dogri language and translated into English by Dr. Yuvraj Karan Singh. Now, we will go into detail in the poem. The sun was descending like a cataract in the eye of the sky. The rain was constantly splashing against the sky, washing it so that it began to look drenched and forlorn, and it was thundering in anger. Dear students, see the word descending, which means coming down. Cataract means an eye disease when the person can't see clearly, jisko hum motiyabind bhi kehte hain. Splashing means falling. Drenched means wet. Forlorn means lonely, when we are left alone, unhappy. Thundering in anger means was making noise to express its anger. In the opening lines, the poetess says, It was the time of afternoon. The sun was coming down to set. The sky is covered by the veil of clouds, like the eyes of a man covered with cataract. The rain constantly splashed against the sky. It was washing the sky continuously. The sky was looking wet and lonely. The sky was sad because he didn't have company of the shining sun. It thundered to express its anger. The sun, seizing the opportunity, pushed the clouds away and crept out. Like a schoolboy, quickly entering and cowering at the back of the class to avoid attention of the angry schoolmaster. In the first line, the word seizing means to catch something. In the second line, crept. Crept is the past participle of creep, means to come out. Cowering means shrinking in fear. Avoid means to avoid something. In these lines, the sun got opportunity, so it pushed the clouds away and came out from behind them. It crept out like a schoolboy who enters the classroom quickly and crouches in fear at the back of the classroom to avoid the angry master's attention. Slowly the pale sun began to turn yellow, and with that its light scattered in all directions. Seeing the light, the schoolmaster asked, Where have you been all this while? Was your slate not clean, or did you not get enough to eat? Is this the time for the sun to rise? Dear students, as the weak and pale sun started coming out of the clouds, it began to shine more brightly its bright golden light began to spread around. It made its presence felt. Carrying on with the metaphor above, the poetess shows how the schoolboy revealed his own presence at the back of the class to the schoolmaster by shining more brightly. By now, the sun was shining in all its splendor. It answered proudly, "What's the point of getting annoyed? There's no set time for the sun to rise. Whenever it rises, there's sunrise." In these lines, the poetess says that the sun is now shining in all its brilliance and glory after it had been rudely scolded by the sky. The timid schoolboy is transformed into a proud and confident young boy. Boldly the son asks the schoolmaster why he is so annoyed. He reminds him that the only one who can determine when the sun should rise is the sun himself. That's why the time is called sunrise. Therefore, it's quite unreasonable and inappropriate for the schoolmaster to be angry with the sun. The poetess wants to drive home the point that the children should not be scolded even if they come late like sun. Whenever it rises, early or late, it's welcome. It's better to be rid of old thoughts and conventions. There is no fixed set time for intellectual freedom and enlightenment. In other words, jab utho tabhi savera. Dear students, let us have a look at the theme of the poem Sunrise. It brings out an interesting theme. The poetess shows her love and sympathy for school-going children. She also criticizes the schoolmaster who punished the students without knowing their problems. They scold children for coming late to school. Sometimes when students, like the son, come late to the school, they should not be treated harshly as is done by the sky. One day, the son was covered by cataract. After some time, sun got an opportunity and emerged from behind by pushing the clouds. It crept out like the way a schoolboy entering the classroom to avoid the angry stare of the class teacher. The sun began to scatter in all directions. By seeing this, the sky asked it where it had been all that time. He asked whether it had not got enough to eat or whether its slate was not clean. The poetess is of the view that there is no point in admonishing the school children without trying to know their point of view. When the sky had scolded the sun for coming late, the sun answered quite boldly that there is no fixed time for the sun to rise. Whenever it rises, early or late, it's welcome. Let us now look at some important questions of the poem. What's a simile? Identify it from the poem Sunrise. A simile is a figure of speech in which one thing is compared with another, always using as or like. For example, as black as crow, as white as snow. The following are the similes used by Padma Sachdeva in her poem Sunrise. The first one is, the sun was descending like a cataract in the eye of the sky. The clouds are compared with the cataract. Pushed the clouds away, crept out like a schoolboy quickly entering. The sun is compared with the schoolboy. Dear students, let us read about metaphor. A metaphor is an expression which describes a person or object in a literary way by referring to something that's considered to possess similar characteristics of the person or object one is trying to describe. The metaphor used in the poem Sunrise presents the image of the sun as one feeling gloomy and forlorn behind the clouds. Now we see the comparison of sun with the schoolboy. The poetess compares the sun to a schoolboy who has reached school late. The comparison is made because the sun pushes away the clouds hesitatingly and starts shining slowly in the sky, fearing that the sky would rebuke it for its late appearance. Now, look at the figure of speech used in the poem. Simile has been used here as the sun was descending like a cataract in the eye of the sky. The sun is compared to a cataract because the answer is the sun is compared to cataract because it's not clear and is covered by the clouds. Dear students, I hope you liked the poem and have understood it well. Stay safe and healthy. Thank you very much.